All right, let's recap what we've learned so far about strings. We started out by talking about what a string is composed of, and we saw how to define a string using a string literal. Use letter var the way you would with any other constant or variable, and then type your string literal in between quotations. We also learned that Swift strings are encoded with Unicode scalars. For this reason, we're able to incorporate any Unicode character into a Swift string, including emojis. Let's make two strings similar to those above, but this time use the monkey emoji and the mobile phone emoji. Remember, to access the emoji keyboard in Playgrounds, you can press Control Command Spacebar. We also learned that strings in Swift are encoded in a struct, and the characters of a string can be accessed through the characters property belonging to the string struct. For example, let's say we wanted to count how many G's are in this string. We could loop through all the characters in the string using the characters property like so, and increment a count each time we encounter a G. And then if we type count into Playground and look over in the sidebar, we can see that our count is 5. String interpolation is another incredibly convenient feature of Swift strings. Here's an example. Let's say we have to convert from an integer representing number of pennies to a string representing dollars and cents. We can use string interpolation along with operators to get our solution. We can calculate the number of dollars by dividing by 100, and we can calculate the number of cents by taking the modulo of 100. Then, through string interpolation, we can take this variable, $int, along with this expression and insert them into a string, and you can see that string here in the sidebar. We looked at some common string manipulations, starting with string concatenation. For example, we can combine our monkey string and our thief string to make a very short story about a monkey with sticky fingers. We also learned that the Swift string struct is bridged to the NS string class in Objective-C. This opens up a host of useful methods, including contain string, string by replacing occurrences of string, and lots more. Let's look at those methods one more time. Here we're calling the method contain string on the variable monkey string, and we're passing in key as a parameter. By doing this, we're asking if the monkey string contains the string key, and over here in the sidebar, we can see that the method returns true. Here's another one. Let's say our Wi-Fi password is meet me in St. Louis, but we need to switch it up a bit. Let's replace all the E's with 3's using the NSString method, string by replacing occurrences of string. And what you're looking at here is the variable name followed by the dot operator, string by replacing occurrences of string, and then the parameters we're passing in are the string we want to replace and the replacement string. And over here in the sidebar, we can see the result.